source problem under control, then this brings our city in the best possible shape. We might need another little farm. Put one here. As you can see, only on the green we can build farms. This is barren land, so we can build houses up there. We can build houses anywhere, but it's obviously better to use the fertile ground for farming, at least in the beginning, because I don't want to have really long streets and ways for my workers to run. So the shorter the path, the better is it. Okay, time for our first quarry. And then, if we have 5 stone, we can build our first forester. Which is probably going somewhere around here. And another one later down there. To just keep this tight and compact. Because obviously we want a wall around this and keep everything safe inside the wall. We have also 3 speeds that we can choose from. Right now, let's play on fastest, just to get a bit more going. So obviously for every industry building, or pretty much every building, needs a certain amount of people that work in this building. For the quarry it's 4. For the little farms we have only 1 worker. You can even see those little guys working on the farm. And for the tree farm we have 3 workers. Okay, nice. So we have our quarry is working. We have some stone now. So let's chop down those trees and set a forester there. And the other one probably I cannot build another forester within this range of the first forester. So this corner or that corner is ideal. And then we focus on the trees inside that, I think there should be enough trees for 2 foresters to work with. I think we can chop down all those trees and build some houses and food, obviously. Oh yeah, we have a dragon. All right, now I cannot defend against this dragon. I didn't have the resources to build anything to protect me, but thankfully the first one is just pretty much flying over, looking around, don't really attack me, which is good. But later on dragons will try to burn down my buildings, and then I need towers with archers and try to shoot down the dragon, or at least damage it enough so it leaves the town. So, food is enough, more or less. We have plus 17 food per year right now, which is okay, considering we have no food storage right now. So we only store all our resources we store in our town hall or keep, and we can only store 50 food right now. So this is something to think about, and probably let's start with that and build a small granary down here. This will give us more room to store our food. I think it gives plus 200. We'll see. Now, right now we have 50. I think we go up to 250 then. Yeah, exactly. So now even the path to the food storage is shorter for the food production buildings. And then we should consider getting a few more houses. But let's first build another forester. Right here. And another quarry. So we can build up to two quarries on one of those white stones. The black stones are pretty much useless. And the bronze ones are iron. But iron is not really important for now. It comes later on when I want to build army or better tools. Also, those stones are indefinitely usable. So I don't have really... As long as the quarries are on the stone and don't get burnt down or I demolish them, the stone will produce an indefinitely amount of food, of stone. So I don't really have to worry in the long run that I have to expand, but... Okay. So I think we have for now the few first things. Let's build a well. So people get their minimum commodities. So happiness becomes pretty important later on. Right now we are pretty happy. Or my peasants are really happy. And you can increase happiness with certain buildings. The well is one of them, and it's right now more importantly to have one if something were to start to burn, that my people can take water from the well and then put out the fire. And then we have to decide where we want to build our food, our housing place, because I think I want to make this a farm, those 9 tiles over here with a windmill in the middle. And then put some houses over here, I think. Yeah, let's do that. So we have to, for now we had those small houses, but it's more effective to build those bigger houses because it brings 2 more space, so they can live, 2 more people can live in those houses than in 2 small houses. Also it is more convenient, or it's more useful to build the bigger houses because they need less road access. If I wanted, for example, build 4 houses over here, 4 small houses, 2 of those houses wouldn't have a road access. If I would build bigger cottages, both of these entire cottages would have a road access. So overall the cottage is more useful than the small one, but obviously more expensive in terms of resources. Okay, food is good, stone is good, wood is good. Let's build a little stockpile where we can store our food and our stones. What's up with the well? Not finished yet. Don't we have enough worker? Okay, probably nope. So I'm closing one of the quarries right now. So we have a free worker who has capacity to build the buildings. Let's close one forester as well. Just until we have this house built. So we got a few more villagers. Okay, Next up is food, I think. So we want a windmill in the middle of this one, because it increases the food production of the small farms. So we build one windmill and 8 farm tiles around it, and all of those produce more food than if they would stand alone. Then we can build another cottage, I think. Let's build it like this. And then one from the other side as well. So we can fill up this entire space with houses.